you're in style. Just forget about life for a while. See the world, through our eyes. Under picture perfect skies. It just makes me wanna, hey, let's get away from your mind. Just once in a while I wanna, just come away with a smile.
Greetings, and welcome to a very special episode of The Adventures of Mark and Brian.
It's fairly obvious we're here at the park, and we're here to learn more about children.
See, Mark has two kids of his own, and I'm looking forward to having a family someday.
I think you may want to start with a wife.
Look, there. I'm working on it.
Now, we recently heard about a lady named Mrs. Denise Osier, who has a very special problem.
Denise lives just north of Los Angeles in Simi Valley, California.
America, this is Denise. And Denise, if you look right in there, you may see relatives watching the program. America.
A few weeks ago, Denise told us about a situation that her and her husband are in. She's pregnant, obviously, and her husband is down in Texas in boot camp, and he's not going to be able to come back for the birth of this baby. So that's what we're doing here. We're going to be stand-in dad.
You can imagine how difficult it is for her husband, Michael, to not be here for this, and for Denise, for Michael, to not be here. So we're just going to do anything and everything we can to make it a little easier for her to have this baby while her husband is away at boot camp.
Are you excited about this?
I'm very excited about it.
Are you nervous that we're going to be the stand-in dads? Because you really should be.
You really, really should be, you know.
These are your wedding pictures?
Yeah. Michael proposed to me on my 19th birthday. Yeah, I was sitting on the couch, I was watching TV, and he came up and he got on his knees. He had the ring box and he opened the box. And he asked me to marry him.
Yeah. Very romantic.
Yeah. Michael's such a gentleman. He really is. He's a complete and total gentleman.
You must miss him a great deal.
So much. He used to put cocoa butter on me coming every night.
Cocoa butter?
Yeah, now it's a bummer. I have to do it myself now.
Well, might that be something that we're supposed to do? Or probably not, no.
At the Air Force Family Support Center, they were kind enough to help us make a call to Denise's husband, Michael.
Hello, Michael? Mark and Brian here.
Hey, how you doing?
Brian, how are you?
I'm doing okay.
Please tell us you're not standing at attention right now.
No, not right at the moment. I was instructed to sit down.
Hey, Michael, what do you feel about being a father?
I just can't wait to get home to be one. It's hard being away.
Yeah.
But I'm sitting here with tears in my eyes. It means a lot to me. Not being able to, it's really hard on me.
Is there anything that you'd like us to do specifically to help Denise out? Anything that she hasn't told us that maybe she won't tell us?
Give her a hug for me.
Give her a hug for you? That will do. That will do.
I love you, Mikey.
Love you too, baby. Stay strong, okay?
I'm trying. You too, okay?
I'm doing my best.
Michael's main concern was our main concern, to make sure that Denise got the best care possible.
Who's that?
So we took Denise over to Dr. Ned Lindsay's office for a checkup.
And while we were there, we got a chance to meet one of our newest viewers.
Can you kiss? Thank you. We all have a responsibility to Denise. And unfortunately, her husband can't be here, so you guys are going to have to pick that up. There's a few things that you're going to have to learn. Now, you've had children before, I understand.
Yes, two.
Yeah. How was that experience for you?
The grandest and most incredibly moving thing I guess I've ever been through.
So, Denise, how do you feel about all this?
It's good. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of support that I was worried that I might not get.
I bet it's coming from a place you never thought it'd come from.
Not so sure.
So, it's okay to be nervous right now, right?
Oh, yeah.
Not for her, I mean for me.
No, because
Dr. Lindsay not only told us what to expect during labor, but also warned us of things we might encounter after the birth.
Colic. It's a not
when
good
your hair
thing.
Stands up?
No. If it were that simple, it'd be a wonderful thing. No, colic is something that can change your entire life.
What is it?
Gas.
Yeah, just a ton of gas, and you can't get rid of it, and there's nothing you can do about it, and the baby screams for like 38 hours.
No colic.
After Dr. Lindsay gave us the thumbs up as stand-in dads, we had work to do, fast.
We had a baby shower to throw, major gifts to buy, and Denise's daughter was due in less than 3 weeks.
When they can start climbing out is when you move to the little bed.
The regular
they
bed.
Get a physical real bed at that point.
Okay. And how do you keep them in that? With, like, duct tape?
There's a few guineas in babies. and this is one of them. We kind of know this is going to work. They dig this.
See, they reach up. They like feeling different textures. See, you think they're trying to reach up and feel it. They're trying to rip it down. I mean, that tune, can you imagine that banging in your head?
I can't.
4 hours straight? Won't the baby be too small?
Well, she's going to grow. She'll stay in this chair for 2 to 3 years.
Yeah, but this episode only lasts a half hour.
I understand. But see, now, we just want to give her a gift she can use later in life. Oh, and look, comes with the Don King hair on top, too.
Yeah, you check it out, the Mirage on July 17th. It's going to be the biggest thing. Typhoon's going to be there. Everything's happening. God bless America.
Baby will always smile back at a smiling face.
You're kidding me?
Absolutely. That's the first thing they study. You ever picked up a baby and they just start staring at you?
Yeah.
They're interested in your face. They want to see your eyes and your teeth and your smile.
All right, now I'm going to see if your theory works here. Can I take the glasses off?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm crazy.
Ooh. So far, so good, I think.
Yeah.
Hey, Gracie. Hi, Gracie.
It's a new toy!
Hi, Gracie.
Now it was time to get ready for the shower.
Doing it all for my baby.
Balloons in the pan, balloons
in the pan. This is their finest secret.
Effect you were going with before is going to be perfect.
Baby shower. How's she feel to you? It's like a pastry.
Yeah,
you can see the bit.
Can Mark and Brian do a show where they're feeling helium balloons without doing helium comedy? That's a good question.
Answer's no.
Nah.
She's having my baby. What a lovely way of saying how much we love her. Why, my baby? I'm getting a major rush.
Oh, God, I'm really getting out here.
Holy cow.
We have a surprise for Denise. And the, Okay, the surprise is here.
We flew her mother from Georgia. She couldn't afford to come down, so Denise thought she wasn't going to come. But she's here, and she's going to be very surprised.
See, what the problem is that we just don't know exactly where to put this.
Now, you can maybe look at it and tell us.
Well, Denise and her mom seemed happy, and so were we. Everything was ready for the baby shower.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, baby.
Suddenly, it occurred to us that we were the only guys at this party.
Well, that's a long reach when two pregnant women hug each other, isn't it?
We were amazed at the number of generations of Denise's family that were here under one roof.
So this would be McKenna's great-great-grandmother.
Right.
You must be very proud.
Yeah.
Obviously, because of the population of this room, you've been through a lot of these.
You people kick up young.
After meeting the family, we tried to fit in. We served our food.
Now, one lady tried it. She said it was a biscuity kind of raisiny thing.
And we even organized baby shower games, which is no small task for a group of 51 women. Denise and Michael had picked out the name McKenna for their daughter. So we decided to make McKenna a video for when she got older.
This is Mom.
And this is you.
And there you are.
Aren't you cute?
Hi, Brian. Cousin in 3D.
All right, now a lot of people know this, but Jordan here can do Michael Jackson. Want to see him? Pretty good, huh? You want to say something to your great-great-grandchild?
I hope you're as good as Michael was. No matter where her mommy and daddy are stationed at, Aunt Lori's always here.
Go with Aunt Lori!
McKenna, be as beautiful as your grandma and your mom.
I just wanted you to know that you and your dad are the two most important people in my life, and you were made from the best love that two people could ever have. And I thought I was really lucky the day that I married Judea until I found out I was pregnant with you, and That's just, I'm even more lucky, and I can't wait for you to be born.
Oh, let's do a message. Here, give me this. Is it on? Is the green light on?
It's hang on, let me see.
It's recording. Okay.
Hi, McKenna. We're Mark and Brian, and we were involved with this, and we just want to say good luck.
And a couple of tips for you, even though it's 20 years in the future, things you should remember. Don't ever cheer for the New England Patriots. They stink now. They'll stink then.
Denise got great gifts, but we were the ones that had to assemble them.
Come in here and see something? Got something to show you.
Oh my gosh.
Like it?
Yes, you guys did so good.
Denise was now 2 weeks away from delivery. She was holding up well, but we didn't want her to have to go through this alone.
We really wanted to share this experience with her.
See, does your back hurt back here? That's where I feel it.
Mm-hmm. I feel pressure on the bladder.
No, this is
hard. Oh, sorry. We're pregnant.
I can see that.
Would you like to see the baby?
Sure. Gee, thanks.
Denise had cravings for some very strange food combinations. Peanut butter and marshmallow cream sandwiches, chocolate-covered potatoes, broccoli with lemon meringue.
Oh, yeah, and corn dogs with lots of mustard.
You know, this is what Elvis's table used to look like.
D-Day was only a week away. Dr. Lindsay now required one last routine ultrasound. In a few minutes, we'd get our first electronic look at Denise and Michael's baby.
Okay, how do you know if it's a girl or a boy? Well, you have to look between the legs.
Thank you for that, Doc.
So you see the, or the, you see the,
you see the, or the, or the.
You can see the four chambers of the heart here now. Okay, the valves.
That's the heart beating. And those are the ribs?
Wow.
Okay.
Umbilical cord over here.
The Adventures of Mark and Brian will be right back. Dr. Lindsay told us that the baby could come at any time, so he came up with a plan to notify the crew when it happened.
Not only do we have to wear beepers, but all the crew does too, otherwise it wouldn't be on video. This is the crew, ladies and gentlemen, the crew.
Here we go.
All right.
Starting with Denise, she's the mom.
Okay, she will know when the baby starts to come because, again, she's the one pregnant.
Denise will call Mark and Brian.
Right, now. As soon as Denise has called Brian, Brian will call Bob, Mark, and Charlie.
We wanted Denise to know the shortest distance between two points is Mark and Brian. And no matter what happened, we would be right there.
Let's do a quick test. We'll dial the number. All your beepers should at that point go off, so make sure we know what we're doing here.
Perfect.
Now pop quiz. Glenn, who are you calling? Glenn? Damn it!
Oh, now we have to go to the whole thing again.
Glenn, all
listen
right,
carefully.
No, call Steve. All
right, we were now on 24-hour alert, and just in case the labor started quickly, Denise's sister Shannon agreed to videotape the ride to the hospital.
There was nothing left to do but wait and finish the final session of Lamaze class.
Brian, can you say hello? Have you ever put a diaper on a baby?
Stuff going on.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Well, there she blows.
Oh,
yeah.
You did a good job. Good job. Good job.
Our most important job in the labor room would be to help Denise with her breathing.
Class? Also, you know, Mom might lose it in transition.
What do you mean by losing it?
Loses a little control.
Meaning?
Gets maybe a little screaming a little bit. Okay?
Cussing us out?
Oh, she might. Could be worse.
Is that a for sure thing that's going to happen?
No, no. Right. May not. Right. And you know, it's not going to do... Oh, okay.
She's 1 centimeter.
Now, how far? How many semis does she have to go? You've been listening.
All I know is she's 1 centimeter. I have no idea what they're talking about, but by God, she's 1 centimeter.
Do you know how many she has to get to?
What measurement are we talking about?
The cervix. The cervix is normally closed.
Oh.
And looking back in retrospect, can you share any of your experiences, Mark?
When you see your child come out of your wife, it is the most special, greatest God-given gift you will ever receive, and you'll never forget it for the entire time you spend on the earth. Very special.
You okay? Yeah. Hey, shut the door. She's not hysterical.
This was it. Baby McKenna was ready to enter the world.
Can we ask you a question?
Mm-hmm. Do you know that it's 2:30 in the morning?
I know.
Now, wait a minute. How intense are the contraction pains right now?
Not that bad.
You nervous or? That's okay, because that's natural, but we'll be there to help you remember the breathing, and we'll be right up here kind of where we are now, talking sweet stuff into your ear.
You should know that we're nervous and scared, too.
You may be reminding us of the breathing, and, you know, because we'll be the ones needing it.
You see this smile here?
Mm-hmm.
And
remember it. Stop doing whatever.
Well, I mean, would you first tell us you're ready to have this thing?
After 15 hours of labor, Denise had still not reached the final stage leading up to delivery, so other options had to be discussed.
They kicked us out. The nurses are now.
Yeah.
And we've heard rumors about a C-section.
Well, that's what I'm here to kind of decide which way we're going.
So. Your wife had a C-section for both children, so we both had to deal with that.
And I can remember, you know, not knowing what's going on at now. It's kind of made everybody crazy.
I didn't know anything about a C-section. It scared me to death. Do you remember that?
We're going to go vaginal pretty soon, but it will be a few hours.
Vaginal?
Probably.
Yeah. Not going to be a C-section?
She made a change. Made some change.
She's up to about 8 to 9 centimeters now, so I think she's going to make it.
Great. All right, we're going to let you get ready.
Okay. A little bit longer, and we'll let you know. Okay, time to start pushing. All right.
The thing foremost in our mind was not to let Denise and Michael down. We may have only been stand-in dads, but we had a big job to do.
Okay.
Not a girl. You're doing good.
Into your nose. That's it.
Deep breath in.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Nine.
Ten.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's good.
Good girl.
Good.
Okay, that's enough. Now just relax until you get your next contraction. Okay, real good. Good control. And you have a dark-haired baby. I could see the top of the baby.
Yeah. You're right. It's going to look like Michael.
You're doing real well. Real good.
Here we go. Ready? One more breath. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
All right. Here we go.
One, two,
real hard, really
three.
Hard. Come on.
Right. Harder.
Six, good.
Seven, eight,
push it.
Nine.
Good. Okay, now
there's
just
rest.
Hold on.
Looks adorable.
Okay, now we're going to get the shoulder.
And she does look like
Mikey. Here we go.
Oh,
little light push.
Light push.
That's good.
Oh, here she comes. Oh, Denise. Oh,
there's your baby.
Oh, baby.
Look what you did. That's your baby. It's a little girl.
Look at
her. There she is. McKenna. Okay, Brian, you think you can do this? All right. Now cut right in between the clamps and then give this to the machine.
I can't.
Mikey, we did it.
Give him to see. That's good.
Mikey, we did it.
Good job, Brian. I can't believe it's over. I cannot believe it's over.
All finished. You can rest now.
Hey, good job, Doc.
Good job, Danny.
Michael, can you see us?
Yes, I can.
Hi, Michael.
The Air Force Family Services Center went to great lengths for us and helped arrange a satellite connection so Michael Osher could meet his new daughter, McKenna.
Can you see your baby, Michael?
No.
Oh, here's McKenna, your daughter.
I love her already.
Michael, she's beautiful.
I know, baby. Hug her and give her lots of extra love from me, okay?
Michael, you're a lucky man. You have a courageous wife, and you have a beautiful new daughter. And we wish you a wonderful life together.
I'm looking forward to having a family of my own, and I just always thought I'd experience that for the first time in my life. So I was kind of... I was kind of teetering whether we should do this show or not, because I just personally wanted to do this on my own, but I'm really glad I did. It's just the most amazing, most beautiful thing. I mean, you just can't experience it unless you do. I mean, you can't.
You got a light?
You did beautifully.
You just can't imagine. You just can't imagine what it's like.
You did real well in there, too.
And hopefully now you can a little more, a little better, because you kind of got to go through it with us. So did you, Coach.
Hey, look. One of those kind, I've been there with that deal.
You said, okay, and do the nose, I'll do the mouth, one. Okay.
Oh, me.
Well, you did real good.
The Adventures of Mark and Brian will be right back.
NBC Premiere Week starts Sunday with the real-life adventures of Mark and Brian.
Run, Dorothy!
Two regular guys living a dream.
We're wasted!
Then...
it ain't natural.
It's Erie, Indiana. The show TV Guide warns, don't miss the real-life adventures of Mark and Brian, followed by Erie, Indiana, premiering at 7, 6 Central, NBC Sunday.
Hey, kids, you have two ways to win. First, watch NBC's all-new fun-filled Saturday morning lineup. Then go to your nearest Toys R Us store and vote for your favorite show in Kid Vote. Everyone wins a comic book and a chance for a $10,000 shopping spree or a new bike. Watch NBC's Saturday morning shows, and you could be a winner.